Jacqueline Antonio Santana has asked us how to paint the bone-coloured armour of Ulthwé Craftworld Eldar. Now, to do this, it makes sense to undercoat your miniatures with Chaos Black, because Ulthwé armour is mostly black. But then for those bone details, you'll need Zandri dust for your base coat, followed by a layer of a shabty bone. Now, if there are any features on the area of armour that you're painting, you'll need Agrax Earthshade to shade it, and then finally, you want Pallid Witch Flesh to highlight it. We're going to start out with Zandri dust, which I'm going to be applying with my medium base brush, and I'm going to be using a Wraithguard miniature for my example, but you can of course do this to any Eldar miniature that you're painting in this colour scheme. Once your paint's thinned down to this kind of point, you just need to start picking out all the parts that you want to be bone. And for this miniature, I'm going to go for the head and also the shoulder plates as well, and with this colour you'll need to apply two thin coats. Once you've finished applying that base coat, you're ready to add a layer of a shabty bone to all these bone details. Now, this is quite a jump, this colour, from Zandri dust to a shabty bone, so you have to go into this expecting to apply multiple coats here. And you can see how much I've thinned it down to ensure it dries smoothly. I'm looking at doing about three coats for this. Now, if you've got any recessed details, such as on the shoulder plate just here, what you want to do is avoid those recesses. So just be careful around those parts there like that, just to keep a bit of definition in those recesses. Once you've finished building up that bone colour to a smooth finish, you now just need to add a little bit more depth to the miniature on these bone details. With Agrax Earthshade and a small layer brush, what you do is just paint this colour as neatly as you can into these recessed details. And finally, finish off these areas with a highlight of Pallid Witch Flesh following along all the sharpest edges, just like this. Now on Wraithguard, on these heads, I find it's a good idea as well just to apply a small highlight in the very centre of the dome, just along here. There like that. And if you have any of these little nodules on these parts as well, you just need to highlight these with just a line following along the top edge of them, there like that. And there we are, that's the Ulthwé bone coloured armour complete. So Jacqueline, I really hope that's answered your question, and I hope it helps you out as well, and we'll see you all again very soon.